Welcome to Triumphant Life Church. We are so glad that you are here. My name is Taylor, and we have a lot of great things going on right here at TLC, so let's take a look. You can experience our ministry online, but there is something powerful about worshiping together with other believers, so we invite you to register for service. Go to triumphantlifenj.org to register for Sunday service. And we are still reaching lives in Asbury Park. That's right, every Saturday at 10 a.m., we are having services in our Asbury Park location, and we invite you to attend. Go to triumphantlifenj.org to register for our Saturday services. Have you been encouraged by a sermon given at Triumphant Life? Do you wish that you could rewatch it all over again? Well, you can. Subscribe to our YouTube at Triumphant Life in order to rewatch all the sermons given at TLC. And our leading ladies are meeting every third Friday on Zoom. Join us as we begin our study on women in the Bible. You do not want to miss this dynamic time of women empowering women. And that's all we have in the news. My name is Taylor, and Triumphant Life is a place where we love God, love people, and serve the world.
Well, we want to welcome you here to another online experience with us at Triumphant Life Church. Won't you join us in a time of prayer before we go into a time of worship? Eternal God, our Father, Lord, we thank you, God, we lift you up, we magnify your name, we give you all the glory, we give you all the honor, we give you all the praise, God. We ask that you just dwell here in this moment, oh God, dwell in our homes, dwell in our cars, at our workplaces, wherever we may be watching this, oh God. God, we ask that you just turn that place into a place of worship and into a place of praise, God. We ask that you just have your way in each and every one of our lives as we hear a word from you and as we join together corporately online, oh God, we ask that you just move in our lives and shift our lives. Transform us and rearrange us, oh God. And God, we lift you up and we give you all the glory, all the honor, and all the praise. In Jesus' name we pray. Amen. Come on and clap your hands with us. Come on and clap your hands with us. So we're getting ready to sing a song. We just sung it this past Sunday. You know the song. It says, I will bless the Lord at all times, and his praises shall continually be in my mouth. Come on and bless the Lord with us. Amen. Clap those hands.
Oh my God. y'all dancing, y'all better dance. Y'all better dance on this stage. Come on.
Your name, God. You are our Father, our protector, God. We give you all the worship. Lord, we want your praises to rise within us, God. We want to be overflowing with your goodness and your mercy and your kindness, God. We thank you, Jesus. You've been so good to us, God. And we thank you.
Thank you, Jesus. Oh, we worship you. From the inside of me, may you delight in the inside of me. Come fill my life from the inside of me. Set me on fire from the inside of me. It's all I want is for you to be glorified, for you to be lifted high. All I want is for you to
to be lifted high. All I want is for you to be glorified, for you to be lifted high. There's no shadow you won't light up, mountain you won't climb up. Come after me. There's no wall you won't kick down, lie you won't tear down. Come after me. Hey, the shadow you won't light up, mountain you won't climb up. Come after me. There's no wall you won't kick down, lie you won't tear down. Come after me. There's no shadow you won't.
I trust and pray that you've been blessed thus far by the powerful worship, my God, that was in the house. And I believe that whatever worship has the power to do, may that spirit permeate these lands and penetrate into wherever you're watching this morning, that whatever you're going through on the inside, that the power of worship will begin to alleviate your life from any burden, any frustration that your life may be going through at the moment, and you will be elevated to a higher level of worship and to a higher level of praise. I pray over you today that as we're about to jump into the Word of God, that something said, spoken, declared, proclaimed over your life will come into agreement with whatever God has deposited on the inside of you, and you're going to begin to see the goodness of the Lord manifesting in your life in Jesus' name. If you're going to come into agreement with us, I want you to begin to like the screen. Come on, hit the screen. Come into agreement, because God is about to speak something for and to your lives in Jesus' name. Well, Pastor Akins, I've been doing such an amazing job on this relationship series, the blueprint, relationship blueprint. And I'm telling you, man, Some of you need to write him, text him, email him. I don't know how you will communicate, but and let him know you are appreciative of the gross information and the depth of revelation that God has revealed to him, and he has been willfully pouring it out to those that have been locked in, watching, showing up, and receiving this great teaching. And I'm going to try my best to conclude this morning the saga we both have been on, and I want to pick up in 2 Corinthians chapter 4, verse number 7. 2 Corinthians chapter 4, verse 7, I know it's a familiar verse. Paul says that we have this treasure, and the treasure is an earthen vessel, so that the surpassing greatness and the power will be of God and not from us. There is a treasure, but the treasure is an earthen vessel, that the excellence or the surpassing greatness of the power will be of God and not of us. I want to talk briefly about our time spent together today on this idea, are you qualified? I need someone to type that for me in the columns. Are you qualified? And as I was reading this verse, so many things became just apparent to me, and so many things came to the surface of my mind and of my spirit. Because now, whenever you begin to read the Word of God, you cannot limit the Word of God to the surface understanding of it. There is also or always revelation beneath the surface that those who are only attached or connected to the surface of things will never be able to realize and never come into relationship with, because God's word is always deeper than how it appears. And when Paul now began to teach through 2 Corinthians that there is a treasure in earthen vessel and the surpassing greatness of the power of it will be of God and not of us, what came to my mind is that every vessel, referring to our lives rather, are defined by the treasure that is on the inside of it. If you are going to experience what you've never experienced before, if you are going to visit places you've never been before, if you are going to have the level or the type or the kind of relationship in this season of your life you desire, you are going to have to be more treasure-oriented than vessel-oriented. Because now, Paul, even though he says the treasure is in the vessel, I'm going to take a theological risk to suggest that even though the treasure is in the vessel, you are not the vessel, but you are the treasure. And often the reason why we don't get the type of results or the outcome in our life when it comes to relationship, be it family, be it marriage, be it business, be it employment, whatever it is, we don't get the kind of results we want in our lives because we overemphasize the vessel and we undermine the treasure. But someone who's watching today need to understand that you are not the vessel experiencing the treasure, but you are supposed to be the treasure experiencing the vessel. And here's what I'm finding out now. Most relationships, yes, are 90% vessel and only 10% treasure. I'm going to say it again. Most relationships today are 90% vessel and they are only 10% treasure. I was reading something and some scientists was giving some information on icebergs. And they said the average iceberg is only 10% above sea level and 90% of who or what that iceberg is below sea level. In other words, now, sometimes whatever you can see about an iceberg is not all that is of that iceberg because of what you are able to see. What you are looking at is only 10% of what that iceberg really is, but 90% of what that iceberg really is or what it looks like is never seen above. It is hidden in the next dimension. And so many people, watch, they live 90% of their lives being the vessel and only 10% of their lives being the treasure. But I'm going to pray and believe together with those who are going to come into agreement with me that you will live the rest of your life being the treasure and you will not live your entire life being the vessel. And this is interesting now because a lot of people are overemphasizing, oh my goodness, the vessel. Everything today is about the vessel. And I was doing some reading and I found out that in today's society, people, watch this, are choosing vessels over treasure. And watch, people are choosing because of how the vessel looks, how the vessel appears, how the vessel is dressed, how the vessel probably even smells, but they are not choosing that vessel because of the treasure. They are choosing, watch this, that vessel because of appearance. And so now what you are saying is, if you are choosing on that face value, that you are going to spend 90% of your life with only 10% of something that you can see and something that you now know. Because keep in mind that you are not the vessel, you are the treasure that's on the inside of the vessel. An interesting and staggering statistic was, according to the SPS, the Society of Plastic Surgeons, are you ready for this? Annually, America alone has spent $16.5 billion on plastic surgery. Oh, I wanted to sink in for a second. Annually, according to the Society of Plastic Surgeons, in America alone, $16.5 billion is spent annually just on their vessel. Because everyone, sadly, makes choices over 10% of what something is, and not knowing that the 90% that's hidden is what you got to get to know. And sadly, too many people are involved in relationships because the vessel look good, but they have no idea of the treasure. And I'm going to say this again. You don't want nobody to fall for you, if I can use the term, or fall in love with you just because of your or your vessel. You need someone that's going to take the time to tap into your life and discover your treasure and make a long-term commitment or decision, not because of how good you look on the outside, but because of the treasure that is on the inside of your life. And people, watch this, will make this type of investment on their vessel because they do not know that God has already made an investment on the inside of them that can do more for them from the inside out than what their vessel can do for them for the outside in. And so now it is pivotal, it is paramount that we begin to know our treasure, because knowing the treasure is the beginning of building up your life. I'm going to say this again. Knowing the treasure is the beginning of building up your life. But more importantly, being able now not just to know, because whatever you know, if it's going to work, you got to be able to apply. So you got to know what the treasure is. That is the beginning of building your life up. And then now from knowing, you have to go to applying the treasure, which is the beginning of the breakthrough in life. So when you know your treasure, you begin to build your life up. You begin to build your self-esteem. You begin to build your confidence level. You begin to build the way you think about yourself. You begin to build the way you treat yourself and how you love yourself. Because guess what? When you begin to build yourself up by knowing what your treasure is, you are placing yourself on a higher level and on a higher standard, where people who are not qualified do not even have what it takes to reach you. Could it be the reason why the wrong people keep on reaching you is because you never take the time to build yourself up, to be out of the categories of the mediocre and out of the category of the desperated ones and out of the category of the vulnerable ones, and you place yourself at such a level and you said, anybody who can catch me on this level, you deserve to have some type of relationship with my life, And so knowing the treasure is the beginning of building up yourself. Applying the treasure is the beginning of breaking through yourself. So now the 90% that's trapped on the 10% is about to come out of your life, because what you know, you're able to apply. Here's what I found out. What do you do when what you have already in your life has the power to work, but not knowing how to apply it makes your life look or seems unqualified? What do you do when God has invested a treasure, and actuality, you are the treasure? Yeah, but because you don't know the treasure, which is you, you can't apply what you know. And now it makes your life looks, and I'm going to repeat again, it makes your life look or seems unqualified. You'll be surprised of the people, watch, that look unqualified with something great already invested on the inside of their spirits. And now if you are going to be able to understand the concept and the idea of relationship, you need to realize that you are going to need to be qualified to really have a successful relationship in anyone's life. And the qualifier, watch this, is not your vessel. Mm-hmm. The qualifier is your treasure. Because I'm learning this now. I'm learning this when it comes to relationships. Are you ready for this? Love is expensive. Someone who's watching, come on, do me a favor. Type that for me. Love is expensive. They say in Spanish, mucho dinero. They say here in Aruba, it's Hopi placa. Love is expensive. And now watch this. It feels good to be loved. It feels very good to be loved. Remember Eddie Murphy coming to America? To be loved. To be loved. Oh, what a feeling to be loved. Someone to care. Do you remember the movie? I mean, forgive Pastor Grant for trying to sing, but you know, love is expensive. To be loved is a good feeling. But now when you begin to calculate the cost of loving someone, you're going to realize how expensive love is. And watch, you will not be able to afford the cost of love only from your vessel. Your vessel will never be able to underwrite the cost of love. If you are going to have a successful relationship, you cannot love from your vessel. You got to pay that payment from your treasure, because your treasure will always be able to afford what your flesh cannot pay. I'm going deep and I'm almost done, to be honest. So watch. You know you have matured in the love you can afford, and you know you are loving from your treasure and not your vessel when you are being drained by what or who you are loving, but you keep on making deposits in them. Oh, I'm going to say that part again. You know you've matured in love. And you know you've matured in whom you're loving, because now you're learning how to love from your treasure and you're not loving from your vessel. How do you know you've matured? You've matured because who you are loving is draining, but you still find yourself making the payment, or you still find yourself depositing. Here is why. You are not loving from your vessel. You are loving from your treasure. Here's a staggering quote I made up. You ready for this? You will never be able to successfully, wow, satisfy a person if they themselves don't even know what they want. I'm going to say it again. You will never be able to successfully satisfy nobody from your vessel if they themselves don't know what it is that they want. And then you're going to begin to realize that love is not only expensive, love can even get you into debt. Love can get you into financial debt. Love can get you into emotional debt. Love can get you into bottomless places you never imagined or thought you're going to be in. Because why? You're trying to love someone from your vessel, and the person you're trying to love from your vessel doesn't even know how to satisfy themselves. Therefore, you will not be successful in satisfying them. And now it gets worse. Because you are trying to satisfy them from your vessel and not your treasure, you're going to end up in a debt for trying to love someone from the wrong source. So love is expensive. But here's my staggering point. Love is two powerful things. You want to hear it? Love is a gift, and love is a fruit. Pastor Akins, you're going to love this. Love is a gift, but love is also a fruit. I need someone who, Pastor say, describes. I need Pastor Akin scribes to type in for me. Love is a gift, but love is also a fruit. Here's what I learned through studying scripture. God gives us gifts. You ready for this? But he doesn't give us fruits. Uh-oh. Let's start over. Love is a gift. Love is also a fruit. God is a giver of gifts, but I'm learning through studying scripture carefully that God doesn't give us fruit. I'm going to prove it. I'm going to marry these two scriptures together. One pastor has labeled the blueprint scripture, but I want to begin in Galatians 5, 22 to 23. Galatians 5, 22 to 23. It says, but the fruit of the Spirit, it's love, joy, peace, patience, kindness, faithfulness, gentleness, self-control. Against such there is no law. Now, remember, love is a fruit. Love is also a gift. Galatians 5 tells us that the fruit of the Spirit. So now, remember, Paul says, 2 Corinthians 4, verse 7, we have a treasure. Your treasure now is your spirit. Now, you do not have a treasure called the Spirit. You are the Spirit, so you are the treasure. But now, the fruit of your treasure, oh my God, because you cannot limit your life loving somebody with your good looks. Baby, I don't want to be sarcastic. I don't want to be comedic, but you're not going to look that good all the rest of your life. I mean, you may look good, but you're not going to, you know what I'm talking about. You cannot limit loving someone to how you look. Paul says the fruit of the Spirit is love. 2 Corinthians 4, 7 says we have a treasure. You are the treasure. The treasure is the Spirit. So you are going to have to learn how to make the payment called love from your treasure, which is your spirit. So the fruit of the Spirit is love, joy, peace, patience, kindness, goodness, faithfulness, gentleness, self-control. Against us there is no law. Now, pastor's conclusion is in 1 Corinthians 13, 1 through 3, it says, but if I speak in tongues of men and of angels, but have not love, he says, I am a sounding brass and a tinkling cymbal. And then verse 3 tells us, love is patient, love is kind, it does not envy, does not boast, it isn't proud, and the verse goes on. The power to this text is now, love is the treasure that's on the inside of your spirit. If you are going to be successful, you are going to have to understand that you are not designed to be loved by someone's vessel. You are designed to be loved by someone's treasure, which is their spirit. You see, there are a lot of gifted people that you meet. But then now everyone that is gifted isn't always fruitful. And watch now, gifted meaning, watch, you know how to say the right thing to get what you want. Oh, let me tell you something. There are people who know what to say to get what they want. That means that person is gifted, but now they're not matured in love. Because now matured meaning you have taken the time to develop your treasure, to activate your spirit in order to learn the language called love. And I'm going to show you that if I have time. So now love now must be developed, and love is a language. So gifted people know what to say to get what they want. But when you are matured by your treasure, matured meaning you have taken the time to learn the language. Here's what I'm finding out. People have fallen for the gift of love, but not for the fruit of love. Can I ask you a question? Have you fallen for someone who have the gift of love, the gift to talk, the gift to sweep you off of your feet, the gift to give you butterflies in your stomach, the gift to make you go cuckoo for Cocoa Puff? Too many people are falling for the gift and not for the fruit. And that is something that people are missing today. You do not want to spend your life being loved from a limited perspective, because someone, watch, is gifted, but they're not matured in it. Are you falling for the gift, or are you mature enough to recognize the fruits? I repeat, God gives gifts, but you got to grow your own fruit. And there are too many trees that look attractive on the outside. Their leaves look good. They all made up. $16.5 billion plastic surgeons make a year because people will invest so much money on how they look on the outside. And when you finally get entangled with that person, you realize they are only 10% above sea level, but there is nothing below them at all. And the danger of relationships is the fact that people are falling into the trap by those who are gifted to love, but not by those that can develop the fruit of love. Because when you could develop a fruit, that means your life is matured and your life is operating not from your vessel, but it is operating from your treasure. Time always goes fast when we're together. So here's what I'm learning and I'm done. Love is a language. But there is a language in most relationships that doesn't speak love, because it's coming from the vessel of the person, not the treasure of the person. Love must not be considered as an expression for feeling only, but it must be viewed as the application from the treasure. Here's why. Having a feeling without application creates a language no one can understand. And there are people who are in love today, but they have no understanding, no communication, because the gift will only do so much. You need to develop the fruit from within your vessel, from your spirit, from your treasure, in order for you to be qualified for your relationships. God wants to qualify you in this season. He doesn't want you just to be impressive. He doesn't just want you to be beautiful. He don't want you just to be handsome or cute. He wants you to be qualified. When you are qualified, you can add the fruit of the Spirit in someone's life, which will only cause them to grow and experience the God side of you and not just the flesh side of you. I'm praying for someone this morning who needs to understand you are more than just a vessel. You are more qualified. And therefore, don't disqualify yourself because of your vessel. There's a treasure on the inside of you that qualifies you from the inside that no one on the outside could ever do and make you feel in your life. Father, I pray for some person watching right now. God, I pray you give them a revelation of their treasure. Show them their value. Show them their potential. Show them their uniqueness. Show them how vibrant and strong their spirit is. Make them ready for the next level of relating and relationships, that they can have the blueprint to map out their life and experience the fruit of love and not just the gift called love. For your glory, Father, I thank you now for touching someone's relationship in a special way. In Jesus' name, amen and amen. God bless you. See you next time right here in Jesus' name.
Hi, welcome to one of the most exciting parts of our worship experience here at Triumphant Life Church. My name is Pam Jenkins, and I'm one of the elders here at Triumphant Life Church. I am so excited on how we ended 2020 and how we're starting 2021. We're going to continue to trust God, trust Him at His Word. The Bible says He can do exceedingly abundantly above all that we could ask, think, or imagine. Your faithfulness in giving has allowed us to continue to support not only locally families that need support with their utilities or groceries, but also those globally that might need support with missionary work across the nation, as well as our partnership with those that are in Uganda. We continue to send help when food is needed, but now in 2021, we're going to help them build an orphanage. Remember, your giving goes beyond the walls to which you live in. Let's continue to be faithful to God as He's been faithful to us. There are three ways you can give here at Triumphant Life Church. You can either go to triumphantlifenj.org, our mobile app, or you can drop your tithing offering off right here at the church. However you decide to give, I want to encourage you, continue to be faithful. Continue to try God at His Word and see, won't He pour you out a blessing that you won't have room enough to receive.
Welcome to Triumphant Life Church. We are so glad that you are here. My name is Taylor, and we have a lot of great things going on right here at TLC, so let's take a look. You can experience our ministry online, but there is something powerful about worshiping together with other believers, so we invite you to register for service. Go to triumphantlifenj.org to register for Sunday service. And we are still reaching lives in Asbury Park. That's right, every Saturday at 10 a.m., we are having services in our Asbury Park location, and we invite you to attend. Go to triumphantlifenj.org to register for our Saturday services. Have you been encouraged by a sermon given at Triumphant Life? Do you wish that you could rewatch it all over again? Well, you can. Subscribe to our YouTube at Triumphant Life in order to rewatch all the sermons given at TLC. And our leading ladies are meeting every third Friday on Zoom. Join us as we begin our study on women in the Bible. You do not want to miss this dynamic time of women empowering women. And that's all we have in the news. My name is Taylor, and Triumphant Life is a place where we love God, love people, and serve the world.